When did Samorus begin to self-identify themselves as Samorus? Guahusipulin. And while today the indigenous inhabitants of the Marianas self-identify as Samorus, this has not always been the case. In fact, before the Spanish colonial period, the term Samoru had most likely never been used by the indigenous inhabitants to refer to themselves. There are several theories to the origins of the word Samoru. The most popular theory is that it is derived from the indigenous word Samoris, which was the name of a chiefly class of Samorus that existed prior to Spanish colonization. Another theory suggests that Samoru is from the Spanish word Chamorro, which can be translated as bald or shorn. This was from the Europeans' observation of the hairstyle of some Samoru men whose heads were shaved, leaving only a top knot on the crown. While people continue to debate the origin of the term Samoru, what is generally accepted is that over time the term Chamorro was collectively adopted by the indigenous people of the Marianas. We don't know exactly when this process started, but we do know based on the first recorded instance of a Samoru self-identifying as Samoru that it had to occur by 1839. This record is found in the account by French explorer Jules Dumont d'Urville in his second visit to Guam, where on the 4th of January 1839, as he is leisurely strolling the southern parts of Guam while also looking to buy food, he encounters a Samoru offering to sell him a cow. While following delightful paths, I had gone as far as 1 league beyond Maritsu without seeing a single hovel. I had unsuccessfully tried to buy pigs, chickens, and eggs in those villages, but they all seemed scarce. Finally, I found a native who offered me a bull that he wished to sell. What happens next is just astonishing. I referred him to the purser, but as he spoke good Spanish and that his face was colored, I thought for one moment that he was Spanish and I was congratulating him about it when he answered me with pride, "I am not a Spaniard nor son of one and I would not wish to be one, but I am a Samoru, or as you Europeans say, I am an Indian and proud of it." This answer impressed me, the more so because the Spaniards looked down upon the Marianos with scorn. D'Urville was stunned by the Spanish-speaking ability of this Samoru man, so much so that he believed for a moment that he was speaking to a Spaniard, and D'Urville complimented him on it. In response, the Samoru man absolutely rejected any identification with the Spanish and proudly proclaimed himself as a Samoru, which impressed D'Urville because he must have been thinking that this native man is asserting his identity as a Samoru despite knowing full well that the Spanish considers the natives to be at a lower level than them. This account indicates that since the 1830s, there was a sense of pride amongst the people of the Marianas in identifying as Samorus, distinct from the Europeans. By the late 19th century, it became abundantly clear that the indigenous inhabitants have embraced the Samoru ethnic identifier. This leads to the following question: why did they start identifying themselves as Samorus? Which will be answered in part 2. Guahusipulan and Pulan has spoken. Esta.